Welcome back to another edition of Audio Fiends. Today, we got new baby Keem and Kendrick. Kendrick Lamar. The Hillbillies. Now, what do you think we're going to get from this song? With the title? You know?
I feel like it'll probably be funny.
It'll be funny.
Based on how long this is, I don't think we're going to get tricked. You know, sometimes an artist, they'll start off with something, and they'll switch to some conscious shit, like, halfway in the middle. I feel like Kendrick Lamar might be liable to do that, but I don't think that's going to happen. I think it's just going to be a regular song, and it's going to be kind of funny, just by the title name.
Okay. I love it with Kendrick. You know, like that statement? It was an immediate, visceral...
Well, you know, because I already know what you're going to say. Let me say it, and then you tell me if I'm right. Good Kid, Mad City came out. That album was fire. He was really rapping. It was good beats on there. The production was great. And then he just went down this path of being a weirdo. So much so that you didn't even listen to the latest album. And I told you that there were a few songs on there that you should listen to that good production, but you didn't even listen to the latest album. But, you know, from what you've heard, Kendrick Lamar, he's just not making really good music anymore. He's too much of a weirdo, and the shit is trash.
I don't think weirdo's my word. Maybe it's more boring.
Yeah, but, he's boring because... He's not that interested in making really good music. He's interested in pursuing this artistic thing that he has going on. And
I really couldn't tell you. I really couldn't tell you. I mean, after To Pimp a Butterfly, I felt like it was hard to get through that album.
To Pimp a Butterfly was a more difficult album to get through than Damn.
Yeah, I got through Damn because Damn was shorter. But it's like, the only song I took away from that was Duckworth.
But here's the thing. Here's the thing about, you didn't like DNA?
It was too commercial at that point. Because it was a single.
That shit was fire, nigga. Look, you're saying it's too commercial. I don't really know what you mean when you say that, but that shit was fire to me. This is what I'm going to say. I think Good Kid, M.A.A.
You don't know what commercial means? I'm just hearing it on the radio. I hear it everywhere. It's like, there's no point in putting it on my playlist.
Oh, okay. Okay. I thought you were talking about, like, in the production or the creation of the song.
No. Really good song, but...
I think Good Kid, M.A.A. is really good, but I don't think it's really good because it sounds really good. I think it's how many good songs are on there? There's like 3, maybe 4. Listen,
we can't get into catching this.
I just want to get through because I was speculating on your opinion. I just want to get mine real quick. I think Good Kid, M.A.A. was pretty good. There's like 3 or 4 that I would actually listen to. You know, you got like Good Kid. You got M.A.A. City. You got Think of Me, I'm Dying of Thirst, and that's really I'm Real, and that's about it. Then you move on to Pimp a Butterfly. There's some good songs on there, like the first song is good.
I like Black of the Berry.
Mortal Man is good. I don't really like that song that much. All Right is good. Then you move on to Damn. You got DNA. You got Duckworth. So for me, when I go into a Kendrick Lamar album, because I know he's a weirdo, I'm not really looking for a whole bunch of songs. There's like 1 or 2, maybe 3, maybe 4 that I get, and then I look at the body of work and I go, okay, what he did creatively with the body of work, the message he wants to put out is great, and that's why he's a great artist. But for me personally, I'm not going in like, oh, every song's gonna be a slapper. Like, I can't listen to you know, I, or I can't listen to, you know, This Dick Ain't Free. I can't listen to shit like that, bro. I'm not listening to shit. Have you ever heard that song?
No.
Bro, it's like spoken words. He's like, this dick ain't free. This dick ain't free. And it's got like a weird, funky, ragtime type of beat in the background.
Like, that was another point I was going to make. Like, his beat selection is fucking awful.
But that's what I'm saying. He's trying to do something. He's not like, just making a song for you to listen to.
Even All Right. It's like, is that him singing in the background? Da, da. It's like,
that shit sounds all
right. I can listen to it. I'm like, okay, this is a really good song. But it's just like, this is not my style.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is like some contemporary hipster hippie shit.
Yeah, that's
living in
cool.
New York.
Well, no, nah,
like a New York hippie, bro.
I'm hearing you. But yeah, he's doing the same. So you have no expectations for this song?
Fucking painter.
You don't like painters?
Sculptor.
You don't like sculptors?
I think I like the end product. I don't like the person. Hey man, don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe. We're about to get into this. So for the producer on this, we got this guy named Evil Gion. He's made Sights with A$AP Rocky and Playboi Carti. About it. Baby Sosa. Fuck are these niggas, man? Sick Boy Rari? Real Young Phil? Alright, man.
We'll see.
Let's check it. This is pretty much our first go around for Dude. Because I haven't even heard that Playboi Carti A$AP Rocky song. I haven't even heard it. So, maybe this is the first go around for Dude. Let's see what he got. Let's see if he made some heat. It better not be some weirdo shit, but hey, whatever. Let's get it. She got 1 million views.
I don't buy much, I buy land, bro. Cologne, Germany.
This is fine. This is fine.
Four McDonald's every time I land, bro. Big K rocks in both hands, bro, and all that. And I'm best dressed moving forward, yeah. Tiny pass on, yeah, all that. Compton Cowboy, all that. Yeah. Big protein. 150 grams of protein. Y'all gotta stop playing, bro. I swear, bro.
He gon' fuck up the world, excuse me, but is that your girl? If she tell, that's a good referral. Heebie jeebie talk crazy to me, but Kendrick know I like the regular girls. I'm not good with the regular girls.
This nigga Baby Keem saving this nigga. Saving this nigga from going down a useless path.
I think I know what you mean. Are you saying Baby Keem is allowing Kendrick to be normal?
And
fun,
for lack of a better term, hip.
Oh, okay.
To what's going on, like making good music that younger people can actually get into.
Yeah, I think the second this song came on, I was like, "There's no way the hardcore Kendrick fans are happy about this."
Really?
No way. But maybe not. No way. I think the people who are really, really, really into the conscious, you know, they're like, "Oh, Kendrick is." And they hear this and they're like, "Oh, what are you doing? This is not your mission."
Fuck those people.
But I watch it and I just go, "This is just fun." This is
yeah,
fun.
Right. Thank
pretty,
you.
Sounds pretty good so far. I got no beef with a nigga having fun. I just don't like it when niggas have fun all the time. Are you not real? You're just a joke. As
that.
A human,
I hate that opinion.
You're not real ever. Look, I'm
is
look.
Fun not real?
Huh?
Is fun not real?
Your life is not just always fun. So let me see the other side. Same way your life is not always serious.
See, this is debate that
you don't have to show it to me. I'm
exactly.
I don't like it. Yeah, no, I'm not saying you have to show it to me. I'm just saying I don't like it. It's which is real.
I mean, that's fine. That's fine and all. I mean, look, it's a weird thing. Like, I don't like I'm not really a big fan of like a political message, a diatribe in my music, but your own personal feeling. This is like it's like a threshold. One is like. It's tough to even articulate. You know what's crazy? Because one of the best songs I ever heard when it's like, okay, a nigga has like a clear-cut message without being too fucking, what's the word? Like that nigga NF.
Sanctimonious?
Pretentious.
Pretentious.
That nigga Jay-Z. He made that 4 for 4 album.
That album was not good,
well,
actually.
Just the one song.
There
Story
are two
of OJ.
There are two songs. Family Feud is fire. That's
yeah,
the
okay.
best song on
Nobody
there,
beats
on
that Family Feud.
Come on,
that was fire. I hear Kendrick doing just like, bro, shut up.
I think Kendrick does it well.
Yeah, a lot of people do. It's just not for me. So honestly, Kendrick, I think he's leaning too much to the one side and he's like, please have fun. Please
damn near want a veteran girl. I just might change your life. We ain't wearing no Giuseppe jeans. We ain't doing none of normal things. So you know what formal means? Critics saying that I lost the plot. Principles, yeah, I'd rather not. Messi about to come in hot. We gon' fuck up the world. Excuse me, but it's that your girl. Didn't mean to possess your girl. Baby, I'm high profile. Don't ever tell them you met me, girl. They gon' think
this is fire.
You really like the song.
You're not hearing the little singing in the background.
I actually wasn't paying attention. I have a problem. I can't pay attention to everything at once. So either I'm paying attention to the beat, you point something out, and go okay, or I'm paying attention to the lyrics. I was just listening to the lyrics.
Bro, listen to the fucking.
I heard it, but I didn't really recognize
it. You read me, girl. 5'7", I'm messy, girl. I'm a passionate Neymar. He got time for your bestie, girl. Niggas know that I'm best dressed. Too high profile to access. I ain't even got a fact check. All I'm wearing is Wells Bonner. Feeling good, I might wear no. And
matter of fact, let's stay platonic. I just bought things that are ironic. Cool. You can pick the bunk or bed. Either way, I'ma want some head. Messi lived through me instead. We grew up around trifling hoes. You ain't did nothing, I don't know. It's cool, baby. I'm too high pro. I'm baby Keem, I wouldn't call it close. Messi, get them girls off the stage. Cause somebody's gonna get taken. Somebody's gonna invade on a one-on-one conversation. I'm ducked off from the world. I'm immersed in the PlayStation. And I ain't worried about her. It's a thousand hers out waiting. We gon' fuck up the world. Excuse me, but this, that's your girl. Didn't mean to possess your girl. Baby, I'm high profile. Don't ever tell them you met me, girl. They gon' think that you read me, girl. 5'7", I'm messy, girl. Famous, but I'm not for sale. Why you tryna possess me, girl? I mean, you know what upset me, girl. Like that when you met me, girl. Cause he'll put you in princess shoes. Elevate your respect, you too. Here's 10K, I'm in a sexy mood. Don't let the homies touch you, move. Yeah, niggas know that I'm best dressed with Martin when I pour it. Just they sardines and I'm big fish. Eat caviar when I'm depressed. Take selfies, I'm in Czech Republic. Cornell, he go check the budget. Part two, lit.
They got one.
You gonna add this?
I might have to. This shit fire.
is it about the beat?
Yes. Yes, it is. This beat is ridiculous. And they keeping up with the beat, man. The beat, the main star. I ain't gonna hold you.
The beat is good. I like the beat. But then, going back and forth and rapping shit.
I think it's hitting.
It's cool, but it's too much of the same thing for a long time. Like, if the song was over by now, I might hear you. We still got minutes to go.
I'm interested what's gonna come next.
From my cousins, never gave it back cause it's nothing. Fuck it, yeah, new devotions. Keep it focused, starship, is that a foreign? She's organic, skin is growing, my heart is going. Like, wow. Split personality, two phones, two emotions.
Like, how?
Where you get the notion,
around.
It's not hard to notice.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a deep, 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 deep ocean.
That's why.
Shorty says she's celibate, I'ma keep hoping.
She's not.
Shorty says she loving me, I'ma be open.
I'll try. Are you hearing these lyrics?
Yes.
This thing said that's a deep, deep, deep ocean. That twat.
You know, that little part right there where Kendrick is ad-libbing him just lets me know that they actually put a lot of work into this song. You combine it with the video, too. It's like they put a lot of work into this song. You can tell they loved it. They got the airport nigga dancing to it. I mean, they were playing everywhere trying to get all the shots for the video. They thought a lot more about the song than a lot of people would see from the very beginning.
You don't think that those ad-libs were organic? Maybe they were recording together, having fun. He was just like,
that could be another angle.
Cause they didn't write this.
No, that could be another angle. But I think you can put in work in something, and it could be organic and fun.
Okay. Yeah.
Like, oh, let me hop in there and do that again. Let me do that part. Let me do this. I got a crazy idea.
Okay.
After just listening to it, just sitting down.
Yeah. All right, I feel you.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely true.
Messi, get them girls off the stage, cause somebody's gonna get taken, somebody's gonna invade on a one-on-one conversation. I'm ducked off from the world, I'm immersed in the PlayStation, and I ain't worried about her, it's a thousand hers out waiting.
And W promo.
That is really right.
W Mans for letting that W promo go.
Clapping it up
for this nigga Kendrick, man. We see how Kendrick can only do so much with the fun. Baby Keem took most of the, you know, the airtime there. But you know, I'll rate it first, since I am resident Kendrick hater. I'm gonna give it a 7.5. I really liked it.
It's a high score for the Kendrick hater. I'll give it a 6.5. That's cool.
That's fair enough.
That's cool. It was nice.
Everything gotta be conscious.
Talking about me?
Yeah, you.
Nah, it wasn't that good.
So what would you rate, like, Louis's just out of Just Wanna Rock?
Six or 6.5.
If that's not an 8, you're glazing.
I wouldn't listen to that.
Can't get into it.
You're saying I should judge it not based on how I like it, but based on how good it is, the impact it has, all that kind of stuff.
I think maybe when you do your ratings, you could add or take away 1 to 1.5 points for your own personal preference.
If I take away 1 to 1.5 points, if it's an 8, then it goes down to 6.5.
Is that what happened?
No, in my mind.
And sometimes you have to remove it and be like, off the respect.
In my mind, there is kind of like a barrier where if I wouldn't listen to it, it's not really getting above. It's not getting a 7.5 or higher. So yeah. In this instance, no, that is.
That's why it didn't get an 8, because I'm just like, am I really gonna add this to my playlist? Maybe I'll see. But for right now, I'll give it a 7.5 because I really did enjoy it.
This.
Yeah.
I mean, I think a part of the enjoyment is the music video. You're not gonna be watching the music video every time.
I took that into account as well. I'm thinking, how would I feel just listening to this in my whip? But I think I need to listen to it in my whip to get the full. I need to really hear the full mix and all that kind of stuff. You know.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was calm. It was cool.
Yeah. Yeah. I liked it. I liked it a lot. Certainly, I wasn't bored. Yeah. I thought we're about to listen to this rest of this dirt. And I thought I was just fuck, I gotta listen to Kendrick. Here we go.
That's what you thought?
Yeah.
I don't wanna get into it. I can't believe you said that.
After what I was saying to you?
I wanna get into
it. Yeah, but I'm different from you. You don't have to get into it. Don't forget to like. Don't forget to subscribe. Catch you in the next video.